That's it, a quick yoga session this morning.
Too much travel in the past 2 days, but check out the view from my room.
Got a little snow action. Just a little bit, right? Woo! It's crazy.
All right, it's Wednesday. Bench day, gotta hit floor press. Going to a gym I've never been to in a country I've never really lifted in, maybe once. So we'll see if I can set up a floor press. If not, I'll probably just do, if I'm not doing floor press, I don't know what I'll do. I can set it up somewhere, hopefully on a squat rack or something. But anyways, we're gonna get that going. And yeah, this is what the weather's looking like. It's around 2 p.m. Did that yoga sesh, had breakfast with my cousins. And I just kind of kicked it, but check it out. So yeah, I'm gonna walk my ass to the car, head to the gym. It's like a 2 minute drive, so maybe I'll record the drive. That ice though. Yeah, now it's icy for sure.
No, everything from the back is falling.
Is this a freaking gym? Oh, is that a gym? So sick. I see cardio. Is that what you say it in French? Cardio. Alright, dudes. Let's get kicked out for filming. Oh, yes. See a leg press. Oh, let's get yolked.
What's going on, guys? First off, I just want to say Merry Christmas to all of you. It's Christmas Eve and I'm trying to get this uploaded, so yeah, it's actually been almost exactly 6 months that I've been on YouTube, and it's been a good experience, and I appreciate all the support, guys. So I hope you enjoyed the footage, and I look forward to bringing you guys more videos and interacting with you guys. But anyways, floor press today was a very high volume and low weight day, high intensity though. 5x5 on floor press. I was supposed to do 60% of my max, which I have set at 285. Because realistically, I don't think I could hit 300 again. That was it would have to take me a little bit of time to work back up to that. And I'm not willing to go super heavy just yet. But anyways, it was supposed to be 171. So I just put 185 on there because I missed the weekend workout as of my friend's wedding. But anyways, 185 still flew up super easily. For the three sets of 15 on incline dumbbell, 60 pounds was not easy, but I got 15 great reps on every single set, so that was good. And I followed the incline dumbbell by 100 reps on press downs. I did two sets of 25 with the cable, and then I did a set of 50 with a band, which felt awesome. What you're seeing me hit now is three sets of standing military press. I actually went up to 60 pounds, which was good because my tries were fried, but since the chest and the shoulders kind of took it easy, I was actually able to do it. And I had my sister fill me on one set here for the chest flies. I did three sets, really light. I lowered the angle every time, so nothing special. I didn't want to include every set, but yeah, like I was saying, high volume, five sets of floor press, three sets incline, tries, shoulder press, and then three sets of chest flies. After that, I was supposed to be skull crushers, so I decided to do one arm overhead tricep extension. And yeah, I'm still following the cube programming on most days, just because I like how it varies the weights. You'd have like, you know, lighter weeks, heavier weeks, stuff like that. But if there's something I don't want to do, or if it's going how I, in a, you know, a way I don't want it to go, I'll just edit the workouts a little bit. So it's going to kind of turn into, not my own program, but turn into something I do for myself. And then who knows, maybe I'll write something, but I don't know. It's not something I'm really trying to do at this point. For the athlete's choice portion, I just wanted to do lateral raises. So I warmed up with a couple sets and hit 10 reps for five sets with 22.5 pounds. And focusing on, instead of lifting my arm straight out like this, bending my arm first and kind of doing like a wing, so as if you were on the lateral raise machine. I don't usually recommend that. I like to keep it a little more natural with like the wingspan reaching out, but my shoulder felt much better bending my arm up a little bit, almost like half of a hammer curl, and then lifting it. Felt excellent. More stress on the delt, less stress on the shoulder joint, so that felt great. So like I always say, guys, play around with it. What may be ideal for most people might not be ideal for you. It's not gonna be ideal for 100% of the people. Even if it's, you know, ideal for the majority, give it a shot and see what you like better. But anyways, after hitting the side raises, I just went straight to abs. Did three sets of dragon flags, three sets of 10 leg raises. And I finished up with just doing reverse one arm tricep extension. If I do triceps like this, my elbow clicks. If I flip my wrist like a hammer and push down on the straight bar, I don't get a click. So I did some of the reps before the band like that. And then I did it, figured I would just add some volume and like this for just as a finisher, because my arms are always a weak point. I have high tricep insertions. So yeah, they always look small regardless of how big they are, unless I go full synthol on them, which I'm not considering an option. But anyways, guys, peace, Merry Christmas.
Has anybody ever seen this Arnold photo? Wow, to God. Jim is sick though. We out. What do you guys think?
Should I try ice skating later? Snap City 101.
Ice fist. Just got home from the gym, guys. It's about 4 o'clock. Well, that's when the gym closed, but see the physique looks. I feel really pumped. And there's strong downlighting in here.
Pepperoni under the cheese pizza, though, from the ice rink arena. Let's try this. It's like 4:30 and I worked out. No, it's 5:30. It's post-workout meal before the big dinner, so I'm just trying to eat a snack. Wow, fire. Damn, dude, ice rinks way better than Papa John's, way better than anything. Wow.
Well,
gonna edit some video, may have another slice, but even with the other slice, it's gonna be about 1,000 calories today. I did an hour of yoga and 2 hour workout, so saving up for the big dinner.